The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, opened today's afternoon sitting on a Tafton as she lashed out on all legislators who missed plenary sittings without formal clearance from or knowledge of her office. In a strict directive issued in her opening communication to the House, Among ordered all legislators who miss and all intend to skip plenary sittings to individually notify her office for formal clearance, lest they risk for the worst.
Whereas we are cognizant that some members are absent from the House, I'm yet to receive individual letters. And I'm saying individual letters, asking for permission to be out of the House. It is strict liability, not vicarious. We take personal liability. Who were voted in individually, not as a team. So I am here to receive letters from persons who are absent from the House formally. And then I will either formally give permission or not, depending on the circumstance.
Among noted that the boycotting MPs can't continue participating in other House businesses like committee meetings, travels inland and abroad, among other things.
Members have decided to be out of the House, then that means they should also not be in the committees, because a committee is an extension of the House. They should not, and this one goes to the clerk, nobody who is out of the House should be allowed to travel. Because you are not in the House, you are not part of the House, you've decided to be out of the House, so you don't enjoy your rights.
She also stretched the arm to direct removal of opposition MPs on squads of parliamentary sports teams to represent Uganda in the forthcoming East African Parliamentary Games, slated for December in Rwanda, which come with hefty allowances.
For East African Games, that will start on 7th. Of December, and as these games start, there are people who have deliberately decided to excuse themselves from the House, but they will want to go and represent Parliament in Kigali. So I am also telling the chairman of the sports club in Parliament that those who are out of the House must be got out of the list. Whether they are goalkeepers or what, they should be gotten out of the list.
As a regular speaker, the chairperson of sports that you are directing to remove others from the list is part of the absentees. So you may need to appoint an acting chairperson in the interim for now.
The House Speaker also directed that NRM MPs sitting on accountability committees, which are chaired by opposition by law, elect interim leadership among themselves to steer committees during this period of the boycott.
Where you have a chairman, a missing chairman in the committee, I want you to invoke Rule 203.5 of the Rules of Procedure for you to continue transacting and elect a member within your committee. I am giving you power, so elect a member within your committee. Because if you have a absentee chairman, we cannot continue doing without two chairpersons in the committee.
However, the spokesperson of the opposition in Parliament, Joyce Bagala, together with other opposition legislators, have downplayed sanctions by the Speaker, saying they're not backed up by law.
The opposition determines what it does, as long as what we do is lawful.
If the Speaker is saying we cannot enter even committees, let her lock the gates.
The directives have attracted mixed reactions from the NRM MPs, as some believe they are far-fetched, while others have welcomed them.
They are saying unless you address this, we are not returning to the House. It is provided within the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda.
Parliament was established, if you have any problem, anything you want, whatever you want to be clarified, come to Parliament. Bring your matter and it will be attended too. But you don't say, I have brought this. You don't ask a question and then you come with an answer.
Notably, Rule 112, Clause 5 of the Parliamentary Rules of Procedure provides that in exceptional cases, the whip of a political organization or a political party may inform the speaker of a member's absence and the circumstances leading to such absence. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.